Today, we're going to learn how to draw an elephant. Now, if you've never drawn an elephant before, it might be kind of tricky to know how to start. Helps to do a little research. So I Google searched how to draw an elephant and came up with this handy step-by-step instructions. So we're going to follow the steps one by one, and it will show us what shapes we need to draw in order to do an elephant. So step one shows us that we need to draw a big circle for the body. I'm going to kind of scooch my circle off to one side so that I have room for my head on the other side. And you can tell from the picture, it does not need to be a perfect circle. And I'm drawing lightly first. That way, if I make a mistake, I can erase. When I think I have it right, I can make it a little bit darker. There's my circle. Not perfect, but I think it's going to make a great elephant body. Now the next step is I'm going to draw the head. The head is made up of some curved lines. So I'm going to start with a line connected to the body, and then it's going to come down and curve around for the elephant's trunk. Then the other side curves down to meet that other line. Now the next step shows some elephant legs. The legs are sort of like rectangles, but once again, not perfect rectangles. So first I'm going to do the front leg. And then the back leg looks like it comes like this. But they've also drawn this line up a little bit to show the elephant's leg muscle. Like that. Now the next step is we're going to draw the other two legs for a total of four, and they're kind of just peeking out behind the first two legs. So you don't see very much of them, just a little bit. Now the next step is important. We're going to draw another line to show the ear. The ear is connected to the head and kind of overlaps the body. I know from looking at pictures of elephants that they have large ears. So I'm going to draw this rounded shape. Very large. It's almost like an oval. And maybe the other ear is just peeking out over here. There we go. Now the next step is we are going to be drawing the elephant tusk. So that is at the top of his trunk. And there's some more curved lines. I'm just going to try to copy the picture the best I can. If it doesn't look just like the picture, that's okay. I'm not going to worry about it that much. Now this step is showing some details, such as the tail, the wrinkles in the elephant's trunk, and the eyes. So elephants have a large football shape for the eye, and then there's a little circle up at the top of the football. And since elephants are kind of wrinkly, they added some wrinkles around the eye too. Wrinkles on the trunk, those are just lines. And of course our tail. Two lines and kind of a teardrop shape. Now the next step is you need to erase any lines that got overlapped by different parts of the elephant. So right here, the ear is covering the elephant's body on top of his head, so I can erase that. And right here, I can erase this. So that looks like the leg is overlapped. Now for the fun part. We are going to decorate our elephant with oil pastels. I can use oil pastels to outline my elephant and to add decorated lines on the inside of the body. So I'm just going to very carefully trace over the outline. And as I trace, I'm being very careful because I know if I rub my hand over the pastel, it will really smear. And I don't want any of my lines to get smudged. And you can choose any color you like. You don't have to outline with black. You could outline with a different color. And I noticed a part where the tusk needs to have a little erasing on the inside. So I'm just gonna keep on tracing over all of my lines, and that's gonna make my elephant stand out really well. Now my elephant is all outlined and he stands out really well. Now I can use colors to make this elephant look like the painted elephants of India. You can choose whatever colors you want, but just be careful as you draw your lines to decorate your elephant, that you don't smudge any of your other lines. So you can do curved lines. You can do zigzag lines, dotted lines. The more different kinds of lines you add to your elephant, the more beautiful it's going to look.